Somebody turn to page 478.
Before you, we'll be sure they get down there and kids get to sort those out for us. We greatly appreciate that. What y'all do. Prayer requests, remember all those that are all our shut-ins that are still unable to come to church and be with us. Remember all those. All the sick. All those certainly on our newsletter. Karen, thank you for putting that together for us every month. We never tell you thank you, but we know there's a lot of work that goes into that. We thank you for it. All those, nobody's got anything, we'll run right into our birthdays then. We're going to go, Friday was Miss Robin Smith's birthday. We're going to let her stand. This week, we got Christy Thompson's today. Braxton Woody's is tomorrow. Christopher Stewart is the 15th. And Friday, Blake Davis, Jonathan Watson's is on Saturday. Any birthdays, any of our visitors having a birthday that we'll get sung to today? Now, Miss Robin, all the eyes are on you. Let's say loud, Miss Robin.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
Any I've missed? I don't have any this week. Thank y'all very much. And I'll turn it back over to Russell.
Chris. Let's do 346.
Thank you. turn to page 408.
Thank you.
page 327.
Oh.
God. It's not for me. It's for everybody, but it's for God.
Amen.
And when I feel something, I can't help it. I'm not people when I feel something. I wish you would cry when you get up there. But sometimes you can't help it when God's on you. And he's angry. You can't help but cry. Always gonna be called praising God. You never will be called just sitting with a frown on your face all the time.
Churning within the Spirit of the Lord, and we just hope and pray that we can just be an obedient servant, a mouthpiece for Him today, that you'll be able to receive a message from God. That's our heart's desire. I'm going to ask Brother Ronnie if he would lead us to the Lord. Ronnie Grace.
Well, Lord, as we bow one more time, God, we thank you, Lord, for this day. God, we thank you, Lord, for the Spirit, Lord, we've been able to feel through the song service. God, we pray, Lord, that we will be here today just to be in a service to you, God, and we must lift you up. And God, that's what we're here for this morning, just to lift the name of Jesus up to the lost and dying world. And God, we pray, Lord, today if there be somebody here that's lost and undone, Lord, don't know you in the free pardon of sin, God, I pray. Well, Lord, you send the power down to so great. Oh, Lord, that they won't be able, Lord, to sit still. Oh, Lord, they have to come, Lord, and bow down. Oh, Lord, and repent of their sins. God, we know, Lord, you would save them. And God, we know, Lord, that you got all power, Lord, here on earth and in heaven. And God, we thank you, oh, Lord, for that. God, we thank you, Lord, for salvation. God, we thank you, oh, Lord, for that. Oh, one, Lord, that we're about to... we're in the season now, Lord, to celebrate, the birth of our Lord and Savior. And God, I pray, oh God, today,
Oh Lord, we celebrate him, God, just like you'd have us do. And God, lift him up, Lord, above the, all the earth. God, you said, if I be lifted up above the earth, Lord, you draw me unto you. Oh God, help us, God, to lift you up. And God, today be with them, Lord, that's lost their loved ones, God. That, oh Lord, when the death angel was visited, God, would you just help them, Lord, and give them peace. And God, oh Lord, knowing, God, they've got a better place to go. And God, oh, we thank you, Lord, for that. But God, we pray for them that are sick and not able to come. And God, oh, them that maybe not able to come because of this old virus. But God, I pray, oh Lord, you just look down in their homes, oh God, wherever they might be. And Lord, bless them, God. And oh Lord, I thank you. You can be more than one place at a time, God. You can be at them homes. And God, I pray, oh Lord, that you be there. God, we pray that you just go with us. God, be with Scott, God, as he comes and breaks the bread of life. God, I pray, oh Lord, the message go out. And oh Lord, when we hear it, we'll take it out into the world. And God, let everybody know that we know Jesus. And God, we thank you again, Lord. We just praise you for everything. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Brother Ronnie, for the good humble prayer.
Yeah.
Certainly was. Special time of year it is for us as Christians, born again believers. Christmas time to celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior. We've got visitors with us today. You're special to us, and we thank the Lord for your presence. There's one young lady that I'm going to have to point out, Kayla, is with us today, and I didn't know who she was until I asked Ronnie, and he was telling me. And she wound up, she is Bud Bowles' granddaughter. And Bud was a great, great help to me when I first told my call. And he went out of his way in his life to help me and to help other young preachers. And he worked very hard at that. I could go into a lot of stories and details about how the effort he put forth to help us. The first revival I was ever asked to help in was with Bud. But that just, you're a special blessing to me today, being here and helping us to go back and remember back. And you come from a good family, good grandparents, good parents, and we appreciate your family. It's a blessing and honor to have both of y'all with us here today. Jeremy's son, and his name is a name that I have trouble with names, remembering them, but his name is Trevor. So seeing I have a son named Trevor, I should be able to remember that. We love them Trevors, and you got a good name, don't mess it up. we appreciate y'all, each and every one of y'all, and Robin back, all of you. A little more strength added to the congregation today, and we're thankful for that. If you got your Bibles and want to follow along, we're going to try our best to just follow the leadership of the Holy Spirit and try to give you what God would for you to have today, and try to crucify the flesh. And I hope and pray that we can just draw our hearts and minds in for this. This is just church service. It's just a very, very, very small portion of time that we have in our week and in our lives. Pray that we would just use it for the very best of our ability for him today. And we greatly need your prayers as we try to gather our thoughts, our heart and mind together, that we might just be able to be used by him. But if you got your Bibles and want to follow along, we're going to be up in Ephesians. In the second chapter of Ephesians, the eighth chapter of Romans, and we may refer to some other places, don't know, but we're going to first read in the second chapter of Ephesians, starting with the first verse. And we spoke earlier that this this churning and this moving within us, we're most thankful for it. Without it, we're just as dead man's bones. I thought about the valley of dead bones and how the prophet asked the question, can these bones live? And how that God proved his great love and his power, and that he caused those bones to raise up, and he put flesh upon them, and they all came together, bone to bone, and he put flesh upon them, and they became a great army, the Bible said. How the prophet of God saw here how God can work and bring the dead to life. And we're most grateful for that today. And if we had a desire above another this morning, is that we would realize more greatly the great love and mercy of God. And that's our heart's desire today for the church. And the Bible tells us that the penalty of sin is death, and sin brings on death, and we're thankful today for everlasting life, that God sent his son that we might not have to experience this eternal death, but that we might have eternal life. And so God is the giver of life. The flesh brings death. Sin brings death. But Jesus Christ brings life. And we know John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. That's why we have the opportunity to have eternal life. A life within us that's apart from the flesh and goes far beyond and above the life of the flesh is the life that's within us through the life of Jesus Christ. We're going to read in the second chapter of the book of Ephesians, starting in the first verse. Listen closely. It reads like this. And you have he quickened, who were dead in trespasses of sins, wherein in time past you walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience, among whom also we all had our conversation in times past, in the lust of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in sins, hath quickened us together with Christ. By grace ye are saved, and hath raised us up together, and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might shew the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness toward us through Christ Jesus. For by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. What about that? What about the great love of God and how he has delivered us from a sin, from the penalty of sin, and he has brought us unto the newness of life. And I want you to notice one word here, quickened, and we've often read this word and thought about this word quickened, and we've often been asked to define this word, and what does this word quickened mean? And you think about the word quickened. Now, God's word says here that he hath quickened us together with Christ. Quickened means to be made alive or to be made new. That's part of the meaning of quickened, to be made new or to be made alive. But as we searched into this word just a little further, we found something about it that I had never known before. And I want to share it with you, the church, today. I love it. Most of you may already know this, but those of you that may not, I hope that I could share something with you this morning. Now, we thought and we talked about the creation that God has created, and how that God blesses with children, and how that the Bible says that we are wonderfully and fearfully made. The Bible says that, and how that we spoke about from the very moment of conception. The Bible calls it the most secret part, place, is the very moment of the very inward, most inward part of the very moment of conception, how that life begins. And that is a great work and miracle and blessing of God and from God. And how that begins to grow, and it begins to form there in a fearful and beautiful way according to the Bible. And how as that process begins to go. Now listen, there is no way that I as a man can put this into the words that it might need to be put into, or I've never been able to experience, and no man has ever been able to experience the pains that a woman that has been with child has been able to experience. But we thought about there as we looked into this word quickening, and as God began to reveal it and show and about how that child forms, that human forms within the womb of a woman, and how it goes through a process, and how it goes through the times as God is created. But we found that there's a time there that I'm sure is a very moving and emotional and most beautiful time in that process, when the first kick is felt, when the first movement of a being within there, another human being, another life that is made and formed by God, another precious gift of God there begins to move in a way that mother can feel that movement. The first baby, some of you mothers can relate back to this. I have no idea what I'm talking about, but I know that it exists. It is precious, I know. There in that first movement that is felt, you know what? That is called, those of you that might be as me and did not know this, that very first feeling of life within is called quickened. That's the name of the word of that experience. It's called quickened. You have been quickened. You have felt the movement of life within you that very first time. And I begin to think about that meaning and how quickened and how the Bible says that He will quicken us with Christ Jesus. I can remember back about the very first time that I felt life within me, Ronnie, a new life, not a vision. something within, didn't he? Oh, I had a new experience, one that he had never had before, and it was a very precious and good experience that he had, that he felt within. Oh, listen today, I thought about Abraham and Sarah. Oh, God had made a promise unto them. Oh, listen, and you can be assured, and the Bible tells us, there is one thing that God cannot do, and that is lie. If he makes a promise, that promise will stand through all eternity. All of his precious promises that we read about that he will do for us. He will do for us. He had promised Abraham and Sarah a son, a child, and he told them he will become a great nation of God's people. It was a promise. They were of old age. They didn't quite understand. They laughed at this. They didn't believe it was possible. But aren't you glad to be able to read in the Word of God a promise that says, for with God all things are possible. Oh, listen today. It's possible with God. That is not possible with man. It's possible with God. Oh, I love that. There's a difference between the power of God and the power of man. Oh, listen, and the Bible said they grow weary. They grew weary waiting on this promise. They begin to doubt God. It'll get you in trouble every time. It'll get you in a place you don't want to be. When you doubt God, it'll cause you to make decisions that you wish you hadn't made. There's no need and there's no reason to doubt God. Just take him at his word. You can do that today. Listen, you might not be able to do that with man, but you can do it with God. Take him at his word. Listen, they moved ahead. Sarah said, I have a handmaid, Hagar, you take. And lay with her, and we'll have a child. Listen, God had promised a child. And the Bible said they went forward with this, that they had come up with. And there, that Hagar, she had a child there. And the Bible said immediately that Sarah began to be jealous of this child. She began to envy and not be settled with this child. It was immediately was something that was not right. And how that, listen, that time went on. And the Bible said then that Sarah did, listen, she conceived. And there she bare a child. And how this child, listen, God spoke to them, and when Ishmael, the son of Hagar, was born, that God spoke to Sarah and said this, and Abraham said, this is not the promised child, for this was not of my work, but this was the work of man. And I want you to think about that this morning. Listen, this was not the work of God. This was not the work of the mercy and the love of God, but it was the work of man. And I told him, this is not the promised child. This is not the one that will become a great nation. But then she conceived, and a son was brought forth of the promise of God. Oh, listen, God said, this is the seed that I promised thee. He come through with his promise, didn't he? And of that seed became a great nation. Then listen, that represents today all the born again believers of the Lord Jesus Christ. Listen, the seed of the bondwoman. Listen, the Bible said that she was of Egypt. She was an Egyptian, which is a place of bondage. That's where, listen, that's who had God's people under captivity, in bondage, enslaved. And that's what that represents. Listen, the flesh and the works of man is nothing but bondage. It will bring nothing but bondage upon you. It will cause you to be in bondage to your sin. It will cause you, listen, to experience death, bondage. Listen, is a terrible condition to be in. Enslaved to the things, to the flesh, and the things of the world. It's not a happy place to be. It's not something pleasant to experience. Listen, that's what it represents. But the seed that God promised through Sarah, listen, it was a free seed. It was a seed of promise. promise. It was a seed that would prosper according unto the promises of God. It was a seed that came forth. Listen, it was blessed by God and was able to grow in number and to become the children of God. Oh, listen today. That's what we are simply. We are the flesh and we are the spirit in the power of God. But the spirit lives within us, and that is the seed of God, the precious seed that was promised to Abraham, that was placed within us. Oh, think about it. Listen this morning. When that seed is placed there in the ground and it receives the moisture that it needs, listen, what does it do? Listen, it begins to sprout. It begins to burst open. And what begins to come from that seed? A new life. Something green. Something that moves. Something that's alive. What about that little mustard seed? Oh, listen, what about it? It becomes green. And the fowls of the air can come and build their nest in it. Oh, listen, the precious seed of God, the promise of the Lord. Listen, is the Spirit and the power of God. To be born of the Spirit, to be born of God. Oh, listen, that first kick, oh, it felt good. That Spirit within us, when we begin to realize it was alive and well. Oh, how precious. Oh, how moving. Oh, you know what I think? Poor Brother Ronnie. Woo! It's still moving within me today. And one of these days, brother, listen, she's going to be resurrected. Oh, listen, and receive her body and be able to live eternally. Oh, with God in heaven. Oh, how precious is that life within us. Oh, listen. Oh, I can just imagine. I can only imagine. Oh, maybe I know how the mother of our children were. Oh, how concerned, how caring, how compassionate she was toward the well-being and the help when it was within. When she found out, she was willing to do anything and everything for the well-being of that life that was within. Thank God for a precious, loving mother. Oh, listen today. The Bible said we are brought together. Oh, listen, we are. Oh, listen, through Christ Jesus. That we are brought together with Christ Jesus. And that word, that quickening, together, that we are made new together. That we become alive and life begins to be recognized within us together. For the first time, when we're saved through Christ Jesus, I love that word quickening now more than I ever have. Yeah. That first sign, that first feeling of life within, that first knowing of life within, that is so precious, isn't it? Now listen, we need to keep that alive and well. We need to cherish it, and we need to do everything as the Mother Church. Do everything within us to eat as we need to eat, and to take in as we need to take in, and to turn away as we need to turn away the things that might harm that life within, that might hinder that life within from being alive and well as it needs to be, that it might be nurtured and that it might be cherished above and beyond our own flesh. How that mother, that precious loving mother, listen, is willing to sacrifice and give up of her own for that life that's within. Isn't that so precious and beautiful? And I thought about how, Brother Ronnie, how the Bible tells us about Jesus Christ, and how I believe I had it marked here about how the Christ, listen, I believe it's over in the book of Psalm, there where I read it, how that Jesus Christ was willing to give his own life for the life of you and I, for the church, how that he, listen, it wasn't just words, but it, listen, it was action, how he gave himself for the, so that you and I might have life, and how beautiful. beautiful. He went all the way for you and I and that mother church. How we today should cherish more than anything that life that is within, that it might be listened, nourished, and kept, and that it might come forth like never before. A beautiful life. The Bible said we cry Abba Father because He has become our Father through the being born of the Spirit and the power of God. We now cry Abba Father. Heavenly Father, that's what we have today. A Heavenly Father, and how He has brought us there from death, from the penalty of death, and delivered us. While we were yet sinners, the Bible said, Christ died for us. And how thankful we are today. And if I could do anything today, my greatest desire would be that you might just see His great mercy and love toward you more than ever before. And that you might just want to thank Him and praise Him more than ever before for that life that is within. The Bible says it's a gift from God. Isn't it beautiful how the Bible talks about our children? It says that they are gifts from God. And then it talks about our salvation. How the Bible says it is a free gift from God. Isn't that something? Isn't that beautiful? How that life within is a free gift from God. It's a precious blessing from God. And it's eternal. It's not a life that is slowly dying or fading away, but it is a life that is made new every day. And it's going to live for all eternity. We have a heavenly home that's awaiting us. We have loved ones that have already gone on, but they didn't die. The Bible said, you never die. They've just been promoted. They've just been moved on to their eternal home in heaven, there where we will all meet and be together again one day for all eternity. How precious is that life within. Mother Church, we love you this morning. We thank you for being willing to bear the burden. And it's not all a burden, is it? There's great rejoicing in feeling that life within and knowing that there's a precious life within the mother to be born and to be born again into the Spirit of God. So let's just pray with all of our hearts for the lost to be saved, be willing. Thought about that travail that the mother is willing, and the Bible says that travail, and how when the child is born, she no longer remembers through the joy of that new birth, that new life. Listen, and I'm thankful today, and I love you. I want you to come with a song this morning. I believe that's all that the Lord would have us to say. But I hope and pray this morning that we would just realize the quickening that God has caused within us, that He has quickened us together with Christ Jesus. The Bible said, as Christ died and was resurrected on that third day, so have we. The Bible said we have died. Those of us that have believed in Jesus Christ, we died with Him on that day. And as He was resurrected, so shall we also be resurrected in the newness of life. That's what the Bible says. So all of us here today that are saved, we've got a newness of life within us. We've got something we can feel moving on the inside. That lets us know that it's alive and well. We need to cherish that movement, that precious gift that's within us. We need to cherish it and do everything we can to care for it, nurture it, and to protect it from the flesh and from all the things of this world. Let's stand and sing a verse of song. If you've got something that you need to do, you need to move this morning in some way, whatever that is, whatever that moving is within you, you feel that moving. And when you feel that moving, there, that direction that you need to go, I pray that you would follow the wooing of the Holy Spirit this morning as we sing.
Page 540 at the bottom of the page.
Oh. testimony, something on Mars you want to share this morning.
I'd like to thank the Lord for the spirit of land and fields. I took off Friday on things. I like to do. I like going hunting. I'll be willing, as crazy as it would, gold, not looking over wood with no deer in them, apparently, because I can't see anything sometimes. But I like fishing. I enjoy those things a lot. I was on my way out hunting Friday, and that stirring of the spirit started on the ride out there. It's about a 2-hour ride. Boy, I'm telling you, it's sweeter than anything else. There's nothing else like it in there. I believe the world can't understand, but I believe each one here that's been saved by grace knows exactly what I'm talking about. That spirit inside of us that we get to feel.
Yeah.
I'm talking about, I'm laughing, I'm crying, I'm sure I look crazy going down the road, people cross beside me, and I'm over there laughing, and tears flowing out of my eyes. Just, y'all. So the trip, right? I didn't bag any deer, but you know what? I had the best part of that trip was that ride to get there. Just as I got there quietly by myself, and I'm just talking to the Lord, and I'm praying with me. He's just laying it on me, and I'm just I'm telling you, I'm good with y'all. I'm thankful for that quickening, as you said, and that stirring of the spirit in my soul. I'm so grateful for that. There's nothing like it in this world. It's not worldly. You can't find it here, right? It has to come through His Word. And I'm thankful for that. I want to thank you for loving me, that's for sure.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Chris. Anyone else? I hope and pray. I know that stirring within, that touch of the Lord when He calls you to an altar of repentance, that lets you know that you're lost and you need to move and be saved. That is the precious touch of the Lord. And I hope and pray. You know, to not recognize that for what it is, that's a sad thing, isn't it? To not take advantage of that opportunity is a very, very sad thing. And I hope and pray that each and every one, when you feel that stirring on the inside of the Lord knocking at your heart's door, want to save you, that you would not turn that away, that you would not say, I don't care about it, I'm not concerned for it, it's not something that I desire, but that you would receive it and be thankful and move according to that stirring that's within you. Be thankful for that. Anybody else in any way?
Scott, I'd like to mention it. Prayer. Melanie and I've got a good friend, like Grace. She's our age. Had cancer. Been battling it, been cancer free. It's came back. Just found out a couple of weeks ago. So just pray for that young family. All will go well. I know there's many others.
Anything else?
Scott, a girl that works with us for many years, she feels like part of the family. Melanie Ehler, they just found out that her dad's cancer, he has the same kind of cancer that Doug Carnes has, but they just found out that his cancer has returned. So they just found that out this week, and they're going to do a PET scan, so hopefully it's just in that one area and it hasn't spread, but he's going to start treatment up again. He's taking it really, really hard. He's real depressed right now.
Remember him in prayer to be lifted up. Anyone else? Okay, if not, we'll dismiss in prayer again. Thank you, church. Thank you, visitors. Blessing to us today, and we hope and pray you have a good Christmas. Next Sunday, we're going to have our Christmas play here in 11 o'clock service. Looking forward to that. So we need some prayer for that. Thank you, church, for that. Nothing else. I'm going to ask Maggie, if you will, please dismiss us in prayer.
Dear Lord, thank you for the opportunity to come to church this morning, and thank you for the message. And I just pray that you be with everyone through the Christmas season and through this week. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.